unit of pressure is equal to, what is the unit of force? Newton. Newton per area, unit is meter square. So Newton per meter square is the unit of pressure. So this is the unit of pressure, Newton per meter square. Next we will see what is Pascal's law. Next one is Pascal's law. So what does it state? It states that Pascal's law states that the pressure or intensity of pressure at a point in a static fluid is equal in all directions. Okay, so it means that at a particular point in a static fluid, the pressure intensity is same in all the direction. Okay, which means that pressure intensity in the x direction is same as pressure intensity in the y direction, which is same as pressure intensity in the z direction. Mathematically, we can write the statement like this. Okay, so how does we prove this particular statement? So for proving this, I am taking an arbitrary fluid element of wedge shape. Okay, so I am taking an arbitrary fluid element of wedge shape. So let this be the wedge. Okay, so having, so this is along the x direction, so I am taking it as d, small dx. Here it is along the y direction, so this is dy. See, this element, this length I am taking as small ds. Okay, see, this is not in the z direction, so this is some other length along the xy plane, so it is, I am naming it as ds. And this wedge shape has a width of unity, which is perpendicular to this plane. That means, in this is the xy plane, isn't it? The width of the plane, width of this wedge is unity along perpendicular to this particular plane. Okay, so the width perpendicular to the plane equal to 1, that is unity. Okay, now what is the pressure intensity? We have to prove that Px is equal to Py equal to Pz, isn't it? So for that, I have to draw a free body diagram. To prove that, I have to draw a free body diagram. So how to draw a free body diagram? We have to represent all the forces, okay, acting in this particular wedge. Okay, so what are the forces acting in this particular wedge? The first thing is, the first force is self weight, weight of the wedge. Okay, second one is pressure forces. Due to the pressure intensity, there are pressure forces. Okay, so pressure forces normal to the surfaces. So in the last session, we came across the force in a static liquid, which is perpendicular to the, acting normal to the area, isn't it? So for each surfaces, there is a pressure force which is acting normal to this particular side or surface. Okay, so first I am drawing here dx. So I am drawing like this. It will act at the exact centroid of this particular surface. Okay, so I am drawing it here, imagining this is the centroid of this particular surface. So pressure force can be written as, what is pressure intensity? Pressure intensity is F by A. Or I am representing it as capital, this is capital F. And the pressure force is equal to small p into area. So I am using this equation over here. So that means this force is in along the y direction. So I am naming it as Py into area. Area is dx into 1, isn't it? 1 is the width of the this particular wedge along perpendicular to the plane. So the area will be dx into 1. So this is the area. Okay, and now in this particular surface, this is P, this is in the x direction, so I am naming it as Px into dy into 1. Okay, and in this particular surface, I am naming this as Pz into ds into 1. Okay, and imagine let theta be the angle. Theta be this angle, and I am naming this as capital A, B, C. So angle A, B, C, let it be theta. Okay, so I have drawn the free body diagram, except I have to draw the self weight. Where is the self weight? It is acting along the centroid of this particular surface. So this is the self weight. I am writing this as W. Okay, so I have drawn the free body diagram of this particular wedge.